This is Sheshachalam from Astro Guide Mysore. Today, let us discuss about the Bhava chart, how to construct a Bhava chart using the Rashi Kundali. I have taken the Rashi Kundali on 12th of June 2021, that is today, at 10:10 a.m. at Mysore. Mysore is my place, so I have taken it there. So the degrees are like this. Ascendant is at 24 degrees, 25 minutes. 24 degrees 25 minutes in Kark Rashi, that is Cancer. So Moon, the Sun is at 27:18 and in Taurus. Moon at 16:34 in Gemini. Mars at 6:15 and you can see that it is in Cancer. Retrograde Mercury is at 25:34 and it is in Taurus. Jupiter at 7:53 in Aquarius. This is Venus. Venus is in 17:38, that is 17 degrees 38 minutes in Gemini. Retrograde Saturn at 19:08 in the sign of Capricorn. Rahu at 16:12 in Taurus and Ketu at 16:12 in Scorpio. So for the Bhava Kundali, the ascendant sign is very important. Now that we are doing equal Bhava method, this method is called equal Bhava. So this is equal Bhava method. There are three or four methods of Bhava Kundalis. So I follow the equal Bhava method because it is easy and it is also a very different style of operating, rather than going into the 0 degree Bhava method where the Lagna is kept as 0 degrees and from there 30 degrees every sign will, sorry, house will span. And there is another Bhava method which is more accurate, which is the 10th house midpoint. It requires a little bit of mathematics. It requires the logarithm, log tables. But with this, it is easy so that everybody can understand this and also use it. So you can also get accurate results from this. So that is what is important. So let us take the Bhava, let us start doing the Bhava chart. First, we will first divide the houses. This is the Rashi chart. This is Rashi chart. This is not the Bhava chart. The houses should not be counted from here. Here, we can see that Saturn is in the sign of Capricorn. Whether it is in the seventh house from the ascendant or not, that we have to check. Like for example, Mars is at 6 degrees 15 minutes in the ascendant. Whether it is in the ascendant in the Bhava chart, let us check. Okay, so first let us pinpoint the Bhava Madhya, that is the ascendant Bhava Madhya, that is at 24 and 25. This is the ascendant. Okay, at 24 degrees, I am not putting those degrees in minutes. If you want, I can just put it in one place, degree, and this is minute. I will not be putting degrees and minutes. If I am writing 24, 25, that means it is 24 degrees and 25 minutes. So we will have to add 15 degrees to it, and 15 degrees we have to negate. So if I remove 15 degrees from 24, I will get 9 degrees and 25 minutes. It will be somewhere here. So let me put it in another color so that it will be easy to understand from where the first house begins. So the first house begins at 9 degrees and 25 minutes. So this is the first house, Purva Bhaga, Uttara Bhaga, Purva Bhaga, Uttara Bhaga, that is the previous half. That is, it is towards the 12th house. So this is the first house, first portion, and the first house, second portion will be till 9 degrees and 25 minutes of Simha, that is Leo. So the 9 degrees 25 minutes of Karak Rashi, that is Cancer sign, till 9 degrees 25 minutes of Simha Rashi, that is Leo sign, will come into the first house. So that means some part of Leo also will fall into the first house, and some part of Cancer is left out. So that goes into the 12th house. So let us go ahead now. From 9 degrees 25 minutes to next 9 degrees 25 minutes, we have this second house. This is the second house. Second house will comprise of approximately 21 degrees of Leo and 9 degrees of Virgo. Actually, exactly 20 degrees and 35 minutes of Leo and 9 degrees 25 minutes of Virgo. So this is the second house. So the third house will start from 9 degrees of Virgo and will be till 9 degrees and 25 minutes of Libra. So this is the third house. The fourth house also will be from here to here. So this is the fourth house, that is 9:25. So once again, 9:25, this is the fifth house. So, and again 9:25. I am taking 30 degrees. I am simply cutting exactly 30 degrees. You know, we have started to cut the cake now. So, sorry, there has been a slight power cut. The power will come back. So, let me be continuing here. So, we have 9 degrees, 25 minutes from this point. Yeah, we got it back. UPS is on. So, we have this 9 degrees and 25 minutes of Capricorn, and this is the sixth house. Okay, so 9 degrees 25 minutes, we get the seventh house. So it is a split between the Capricorn Rashi and the Aquarius. We have the seventh house, so you can see that this split and this split will align. So once again, from here we take another 9:25 and you get the 8th house, and then we get 9:25 in Aries and you get the 9th house. Then you have 9:25 here. And you get the 10th house. Then you have one more 9:25. There you get the 11th house. Anyway, we have already done this mapping. So this is the 12th house. So this is how the Bhava chart is to be plotted. This you can do it in your mind if you are a little faster in the mathematical thing, but still better do it by hand so that you will not do any mistakes. Nowadays you get the Bhava Chalit or the equal Bhava chart in the computer. Before you start using a software, better authenticate it manually. So because we know this now, we know how an equal Bhava chart is to be authenticated. You can verify it. You take a chart there, you make it manually, you prepare a Bhava chart, you verify it. You know, you can do those small minor variations like trying to put the Lagna at the first degree of the ascendant, then put it at 29th degree of the ascendant and verify. That is how it has to be done. Don't keep the Lagna at 15 degrees in the midpoint. No change will happen in the Bhava chart. So it happens, the change in the Bhava chart happens when the ascendant is on the ending of the sign or in the starting of the sign. So now it is in the ending of the sign. There are only around 5 degrees and 35 minutes left here. Okay, let us start plotting the planets. Yeah. So now we should see now whether Mars is going to get posited inside the ascendant or not. So 9 degrees 25 minutes, Mars is at 6:15, it is somewhere here. So let me erase this point. So this is 9:25. So Mars is here. Mars is here at 6:15. That means Mars will give you the results, major part of its results, as it is in the 12th house. Why I am telling major part is because Mars is not in the exact center of the 12th house. It is on the edge of the 12th house. If I take the 12th house and the first house, if I make a separate division of it, you will understand. If this is the division, that is the 9 degrees and 25 minutes, and this is the ascendant, and it is at 24-25, right? Yeah, 24 degrees and 25 minutes. Mars is somewhere here at 6 degrees and 15 minutes. So that means it is not in the center point. This is the center of the 12th house. It is not there. It is not in the center. This is the first house. I'm just giving you a perspective of the, you know, view of the first house and the 12th house. If this is the first house and the 12th house, I am just keeping it like this to show you. So Mars is on the edge of the 12th house. It is more near to the first house, but still it will, a major part of the Mars, like around 65-70% of the Mars will give the results of the 12th house. A little bit of it will give you the results of the first house. So let us now go ahead. We'll plot the other planets also. I just gave Mars because it is in the ascendant. Now let us see what happens to Ketu. Ketu is at 16:12. So 16 degrees 12 minutes, very much it is here in the 5th house. Between 9 degrees 25 minutes to 30 degrees, it is inside that 16 degrees. So next is Saturn. Saturn is at 19 degrees 08 minutes. So it is after 9:25. So Saturn is at 19 degrees 08 minutes. Jupiter is at 7:53. So now you can see that Jupiter does not go into the 8th house. It now falls in the 7th house. So in the Bhava Kundali, you can see that Jupiter and the retrograde Saturn are together. Okay. So that is because of the, you know, it tends to come this side because of the split of the house. It moves that side. Split is at 9:25. Jupiter is at 7:53. So next, if I go to Sun, Sun is at 27:18. So 27:18, Sun is somewhere here. So it is well posited in the 11th house. So next is Mercury retro. 25:34, Mercury is also very much well posited inside the, in the same, the Rashi and the house are somewhat same for these all, these two planets. So next is Rahu. Rahu is at 16:12. This is between 9:25 and 30. So Rahu is also placed there. Okay. After that we have Shukra at 17:38 means it is here. It is after 9:25. So Shukra is here. And we have Chandra at 16:34. That is also after 9:25. So we have done all the planets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this is one thing which is the ascendant. Ascendant is also done. So 10 points have been correctly seen. So if I go to the Bhava chart, if I'll draw a small Bhava chart so that it will be easy for us to understand what actually has happened. I'm just putting a small chart because I don't have to write any degrees there, or just to make it, make you people understand that the positions will actually change, and this is how the Bhava chart will look. So this is how the Bhava chart will look now. The ascendant will be same in that position. This is called as the first house. You can start seeing numbers now in the Bhava chart. This is not fully, this first house what I have been pointing out here is not fully Karka Rashi or Cancer sign. We know that a part of Leo is also included here.
Almost one third.
Yeah, almost one third of Leo is included. So, Leo is included here. So we should understand that some Karak Rashi is included here.
One question.
Yeah.
So that means the characteristics of a person,
it will get blended exactly, because he will not have only one Rashi to be in the Lagna, so it will get blended. That is, he will have one third of his character which is coming out of Leo, the other two third of the character coming out of Karak Rashi. And very clearly the Punarvasu Nakshatra which was there in this particular piece is not at all affecting the person's character. Why? Because the ascendant is not in the Punarvasu Nakshatra, it doesn't fall in the ascendant. But the Makha Nakshatra, which actually is till 10 degrees of Makha Nakshatra is there in Leo, Ketu's Nakshatra, 90% of Makha Nakshatra is inside the ascendant now. So, Makha Nakshatra plays an important role. So, that means Pushya, Ashlesha and Makha, these Nakshatras are now strong and they have full effect over the ascendant's character and behavior. And this is how it has to be done. We are not supposed to simply get, you know, tied up with the Rashi chart and simply talk about the Rashi chart. There are many people who don't go into the Bhava chart. They keep explaining about the yogas. They will tell, wow, you have a yoga here. Where is the yoga? I'll tell you, I'll come to that point. There are many yogas which will actually fail. Once you go to the Bhava chart, you'll understand that.
One more question. Mm-hmm. Like now, if a person wants to know, when will the Cancer be more active? When will the Leo part of his will be more active? So, how do we define that? How do we answer?
The more the midpoint tends towards the midpoint of the ascendant, the more the midpoint tends towards a particular Rashi, the more the tendency of the character of the person towards that particular Rashi. Like in this case, the midpoint of the ascendant is very clearly placed in Cancer. And it is placed in Ashlesha Nakshatra. Because Ashlesha Nakshatra starts from 16 degrees 40 minutes. And it is around 13 degrees 20 minutes. 13 degrees 20 minutes. So it starts at 16 degrees 40 minutes. So that is how it becomes 30 degrees. So because of this 16 degrees 40 minutes means it is very much inside Ashlesha Nakshatra. And the person will get full character of the Ashlesha Nakshatra in this horoscope. But the tendency to have the character of Makha Nakshatra is very high, because it is what we call as the forward Nakshatra, not the backward Nakshatra. That is, this is the face. The face is here. The first Drekkana is the face. That is what I have explained. The head and the face, the scalp. So, it is more towards this side, and this side it will be the 12th house. You know, the anus and what we have seen, so many other parts of the bodies will all be this side. So, we need to understand that the first span of 30 degrees on either side is important, but from starting from the ascendant, the coming next 15 degrees are very important to understand the character of the person. So, let us know, I will finish plotting the chart. So this is the ascendant which is falling in that particular sign. Majorly it is in that sign. So next, second house, nothing is there in the second house. Third house, nothing is there. Fourth house also nothing is there. Fifth house we have Ketu. Sixth house, there is nothing in the sixth house. Seventh we have Jupiter and retro Saturn. So that is what's the change, major change. And then we have nothing here in the 8th, 9th and the 10th. In the 11th house we have Rahu, Surya and retro Buddha. Then in the 12th we have Shukra, Chandra and Mangala. So here we can see the two planets, that is one is Mars and the other one is Jupiter, have changed positions. They have gone back by one house. That is because of the... See, when we see the Bhava chart, you should not understand. I'm just telling you once again. We should not understand that Jupiter is placed in Capricorn. No. When you are telling a sign, when you are speaking about a sign, see the Rashi chart. Jupiter is placed very much in Aquarius. but it will give you the results of the seventh house. So this is how some places yogas will not manifest. For example, there might be a Buddha Aditya yoga in the Rashi chart. It is very much evident that Buddha Aditya yoga is there. In this case, it is still there. But when we go to the Bhava chart, Buddha will go to the next house, Sun will be this side. The gap between Buddha and Chandra is, Buddha and Surya is so big that there is no Buddha Aditya yoga at all. And the same way happens with many yogas like Sasa yoga, like Gajakesari yoga, Amala yoga, and so many other things. We need to see the exact Bhava chart along with the essence and the strength and the status, that is what we call as the avasthas, from the Rashi chart. The Bhava chart and the Rashi chart both put together gives us the understanding of the yogas, and that is why I am doing this Bhava chart today, so that when I talk to you about the yogas, you will not go blank. You don't have to go blank. You need to understand that this is how the Bhava chart is done, and use this Bhava chart to understand the effects of the planets on the horoscope. So I think this is fine for today, and thank you very much for today's class.